What is up, YouTube? I Hate Buffering here, aka Chris, aka CJ Man, back today with another. We got more Ice Nine kills. It's been a hot minute since I did a reaction. The last one I did was, it was about it, man. It was crazy. It was crazy. You guys told me that, you know, they have a whole album based on horror films, you know. So it's the month of October. It is actually the 26th. If you guys want me to check out a lot of those songs before October ends, let me know. We're going to start with Stabbing in the Dark. Now, make an assumption here. Stabbing in the Dark. Who is notorious for that? MM's notorious for that, you know? The Boogeyman, right? I'm making assumptions. We're gonna get on with this, man. Before the video begins, make sure you go down below, leave a like, leave a comment. We got 8 minutes, a whole nice story, movie, song here. Before this video begins, make sure you go down below, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe if you're new, ring the bell so you'll be notified when I do upload. You can subscribe if you want. If you enjoyed this, let me know, leave a like. Let's go. Stabbing in the Dark. Ice Nine Kills presents. We get a whole movie, man. Yeah, it's gonna fly. The silver screen. Part 4, Stabbing in the Dark. Ice Nine Spencer. Sometimes, wait, hold on. Time style as his Ice Nine Kills is abbreviated for Inc., an American metalcore band from Boston, Massachusetts, who were best known for horror-inspired lyrics. Ice Nine Kills formed in the earliest incarnation in 2002 by high school friend Spencer. Group originally pursued a style combining punk rock, emo, post-hardcore, and ska, S-K-A, into their own innovative blend of rock, but have since described as theatric core, metalcore, and symphonic metal. Is currently the only remaining founder member. Nice backstory. All right, cool. It's good to throw that in there, right? Music scene at the age of 18 with seemingly no past. Interesting. Suicides plague Blairston, New Jersey, was once seemingly quiet town in New Jersey. The sprawling suburb has been quite a transformation lately, however, due to suicides. Interesting. I was there. Bodies found hanging from.
Well, I'm glad you've come back, Spencer.
Well, the nightmares don't appear to be going anywhere anytime soon, Doctor.
I'm sure.
He's a shrink.
In your last session, you seemed reticent to delve into the memories of your childhood. I just feel like that if we can probe those childhood memories, it may help us get to the root cause of the problem, as opposed to just regurgitating the same old new nightmares.
It's funny that you say that, because my most recent nightmares have been about myself as a child.
And you're sure it was a dream and not a memory?
Well, that's what was so strange about it. I'm dreaming about myself as a child, but also as a spectator, sort of watching the story unfold from the outside.
Well, it can be common in childhood recollections. I mean, if we are told something happened to us and don't quite remember it.
So, I'm a little boy, and I've got a babysitter, and she looks
the whole
very
story.
Much like my colleague, Dr. Stonebridge. My parents are out of town, and she invites her friends over.
Bro.
And they bring booze and drugs.
Who else? You guys know the movie. I'm not gonna say it yet. M.M., bro, he's describing it here.
Come on.
And they invite guys over. But the guys that come over are the guys from my band.
Oh,
and
shit.
One of them has a girlfriend that looks just like your receptionist, Karen. And I just remember being so nervous that my parents are going to come home and that everyone's going to get into trouble.
In trouble with your parents, though, it's not exactly the kind of grisly stuff your nightmares are normally made of, now, is it?
Well, if only it were trouble with just parents. I didn't tell you about the Shadow Man.
In calculated silence, captivated. Put my man in asylum. Violence of replay. 15 years ago today. Oh, an evil evolution will bring a feeble institution to its knees. Oh, doctor, can't you see that when the hands of fate from the midnight hour behind this mask of hate are down the devil's power. These are the devil's eyes. Wait, whoa, what the fuck? Spencer. Dude, look at look at the eyeball, dude. Is my man Spencer M.M., bro? Is that what is that what's going on here? It can't be, because he said he was relaying the vision of him being a small child and it happening. Oh, God. Oh, God, the eyeballs. I remember that, dude, in the movie, man. He's... Ah! Woo! Oh, it's him! It's him! I told you! I guess the other guy you could say was Ghostface, but... I mean, it's Michael, bro. It's fucking Michael, bro.
Down the street, the choice is yours.
I called it, dude! I'm right! Yo! Hold on, whoa, back it up. Nine-year-old child whose name has not been released of this publication was found the only survivor of the Orange Grove Halloween slayings has left a total of five teens and young police officers dead. The boy was found after a neighbor noticed it appeared to be actual blood all over him when he came to her door around midnight asking for candy. A mental patient for life and sentence for killing his sister 15 years ago escaped from Smith's Grove Sanitarium August 38th, leaving the security guard 37-year-old Dan Unum brutally slaughtered in his wake. The patient has been identified as 24-year-old Michael Audrey Myers and has been in what officials have described as a near... Bro, didn't I call it? Am I right? He's the only one that's found there. Come on, expose it. Bro, he said it himself. Part is this? I'm right. I'm out of here.